Hi Math C students, here is an example of using the double angle formulas to find sine, cosine, and the quadrant that 2 theta is in. So we're given that cosine of theta is equal to 2/3 and the tangent of theta is negative. And we don't know it yet, but theta is in quadrant 4. We know that because cosine is positive and tangent is negative, so theta is in quadrant 4. We're also going to need to find sine of theta because to find sine of 2 theta, we're going to use the formula that sine of 2 theta is equal to 2 sine of theta cosine theta. And I don't know sine theta yet, so I'm going to draw a triangle for that. Cosine of theta is adjacent over hypotenuse, which is 2/3. We can find the third side using the Pythagorean theorem. It's called x. 2 squared plus x squared equals 3 squared. X squared equals 9 minus 4. X equals the square root of 5. So we know that sine of theta is going to be the negative square root of 5 over 3 because it is in quadrant 4, where sine is negative. So this is going to be 2 times negative root 5 over 3. And then cosine theta is going to be 2/3. So that's going to be 2 over 1 times negative root 5 over 3 times 2 over 3. It's going to be negative overall. 2 times 2 is 4 times root 5. Over 3 times 3, which is 9. Cosine 2 theta. I always remember this formula. It's cosine squared theta minus sine squared theta. You could also have used the alternative formula 2 cosine squared theta minus 1, especially since you're already given theta. But anyway, cosine of theta is 2/3, so it's going to be 2/3 squared. And then the sine of theta is negative root 5 over 3. So it's going to be negative root 5 over 3. Squared. And then when I square each of those, I get 4 over 9 minus 5 over 9, which is negative 1 over 9. So then to answer the third question, what quadrant is 2 theta in? 2 theta must be in quadrant 3 because both sine of 2 theta and cosine of 2 theta are negative. And when sine and cosine are both negative, we're in quadrant 3. Let's do a second example. Same idea. Here, tangent of theta is equal to 2/3, and sine of theta is negative. So if tangent is positive and sine is negative, we must be in quadrant 3. And then I'm going to draw the triangle so I can find cosine. Because again, if I'm trying to find sine of 2 theta, I know that sine of 2 theta is equal to 2 sine theta cosine theta. And I actually don't know what either sine or cosine is yet. So let's draw the triangle. Tangent of theta is 2 over 3, opposite over adjacent. Finding the third side, 2 squared plus 3 squared equals x squared. 4 plus 9 is 13. Take the square root of the side, so x is the square root of 13. So then sine of 2 theta is going to equal 2 times sine of theta is opposite over hypotenuse, so it's going to be 2 over root 13, except it's negative because we're in quadrant 3 where sine and cosine are both negative. And cosine is going to be 3 over root 13, except negative 3 over root 13. So multiply the tops together. 2 times 2 times 3 is 4 times 3, which is 12. And it is positive because it's a negative times a negative. 1 times root 13 is just 13. So sine of 2 theta is 12 over 13. Cosine of 2 theta is going to be cosine squared theta minus sine squared theta. Cosine squared theta is going to be what we just did before, right? Negative. So cosine theta is negative 3 over root 13 squared. Sine squared, or sine theta, sine of theta is negative 2 over root 13. And then square that. So we're going to get 3 squared is 9 over root 13 squared is 13 minus negative 2 squared is 4 over 13. And 9 minus 4 is 5 thirteenths. And here, since sine of 2 theta is positive and cosine of 2 theta is also positive, we can say that 2 theta must be in quadrant 1. So there's a couple examples of how to use the double angle formulas to figure out what sine of 2 theta and cosine of 2 theta are based on knowing either tangent or sine or cosine of the original angle theta.